Mr. Yechury, the CPIM-led government ran West Bengal for 3.5 decades. And now, as people watch you here at the India Today Conclave, they wonder what's left of the left. How do you, as party general secretary, view the role of the CPIM in particular and the left front in general in this assembly election?
Well, all I can say right now is that people who are watching us and who have watched us for 3.5 decades must actually be hoping for that return. They want those days to return when you have... They would want those days to return because that's... You never had this sort of a mayhem that you're seeing today that's spread all over. So what is left of the left is the future. That is
how
the left.
Is that? I want to talk about whether you believe that the left has a tangible, actionable roadmap for recovery and a strategy to come back to power.
Of course we have.
What is that?
Of course we have. You look at the state of affairs in Bengal today, apart from the country, it's part of the country. But in Bengal, you have unemployment rising, galloping. You have the youth absolutely, you know, wondering where to go, what to do, and most of them are going outside the state, both for jobs and for education. You have your agriculture in doldrums. You have the state finances in absolute doldrums. This is the highest debt ever that's happened. Now, all this, if it has to be changed, you require a concrete game plan. And that concrete game plan is, Bengal used to be the state with the highest number amount of small savings, highest amount. Now that is plummeted. Why? Because there's nothing in the hands of the people to save. Now if these things have to be changed, you require an infrastructural development. For that, resources will have to be mobilized. And that resource mobilization will have to be done and resources used for the development of the state and the people. That concrete roadmap is there. I mean, it is there with us, it is being told to the people, and a large number of people are accepting it. Otherwise, how do you explain this youth yesterday? This massive turnout, much beyond what we had anticipated.
But the reality is, when you formed the government, you had 36-37% of the vote share. For example, in 2001, you had 36.59% of the vote share, 2006, 37.13%. In the Lok Sabha elections of 2019, you came down to 6.28% of the vote share. That's 1/6 of where you used to be.
It's a Lok Sabha election.
No, take Number the last one. Assembly. Even in the last assembly, you were down to 20%.
Yeah. We were down 20%. There's no doubt about it because the question is that of an alternative. Are you going to give an alternative? Or do you want people to elect you only for your representation in the assembly? That alternative was not able to be projected in the last elections. Now, with this understanding that has come about for seat sharing with the Congress and with larger other parties, not only the left front but also with the non-left front party, this is a much credible alternative for forming a government here, which people see, and that's why we given the call for a secular democratic alternative.
But the reality, political reality is that the 2021 assembly election is being seen as a direct battle between the Trinamool Congress and the BJP, with the left, the Congress and all their allies just really being players in the fringes and the margins.
But remember, the left and the Congress were not in that sense together, you know, on the basis of any firm understanding on the seats. It was a loose sort of a combination. And secondly, that is the projection, the entire media included, apart from the two principal parties, project a binary. They think it is either this or that. And why is it in the parliament elections the BJP gained? That's because of the very high degree of anti-incumbency that the Trinamool government suffers from. In fact, that anti-incumbency is deepened further. And therefore, our objective is to defeat the BJP. If you have to defeat the BJP, politics is not arithmetic. Many people say that why don't all of you get together to defeat the BJP? But the reason why the BJP gained in the last Lok Sabha election is because of this anti-incumbency vote, it could pull and pull. And that anti-incumbency vote, if everybody is together, BJP's winning is a sure shot. No, that is why if you want to defeat the BJP, you have to give a credible alternative, which also means an alternative against the Trinamool Congress.